Does your partner loudly snore at night? Or is that a common complaint you hear about yourself? Snoring can be annoying for anyone in the room, but if you or someone you know whose snoring comes with snorting, there could be something more serious going on. And it's called sleep apnea. This sleeping condition is not something to be taken lightly and shouldn't be ignored like it most commonly is amongst adults. Sleep apnea. Whether you've heard of it before or are just learning about it now, is a condition where your breathing gets disrupted while you're sleeping. This medical condition occurs when your upper airway muscles face disruptions while inhaling, preventing you from getting a continuous oxygen supply and leaving your body unable to function correctly. If left untreated, sleep apnea can lead to repercussions. But how do we differentiate between sleep apnea and regular snoring? And who's at risk? We'll explore these questions and many more, so without further delays, let's dive deeper into the topic. Sleep apnea versus regular snoring. Sleep apnea comes with various symptoms, while regular snoring is relatively harmless. Snoring is caused by the vibration of relaxed tissues of your airway. These sagging tissues block the smooth flow of oxygen. But sometimes, this blockage aggravates your body to such an extent that you wake yourself up, which could be serious enough to indicate sleep apnea. Snoring is just partially obstructed breathing, a low-key nuisance for whoever sleeps next to you. If you are a loud snorer, you are not only disturbing your sleep quality, but also disrupting the sleep patterns of the person next to you. Generally, you don't need to worry about snoring if it only happens once in a while due to tiredness or if you're overweight. Sleep apnea, on the contrary, is much more serious. It involves regular loud snoring and severe breathing disruptions, including choking and gasping. During sleep apnea, snores are much louder than normal, and restlessness is common. A study showed that 100 million people worldwide suffered from sleep apnea, and 22 million people alone in the U.S. contribute to these stats. The U.S. has a population of roughly 330 million, which means one out of every 12 people in the U.S. is suffering from sleep apnea. Shockingly, 75% of people are entirely clueless about their disorder. There are two types of sleep apnea. Obstructive sleep apnea. The most common condition occurs when your upper respiratory tract faces severe blockages while sleeping, completely blocking the oxygen flow. The soft tissue at the back of your throat collapses and you face difficulty in breathing due to a partially or entirely blocked airway. Oxygen supply is limited and may cause uneven heart rhythms. So, to compensate for the low oxygen supply, your chest muscles and diaphragm must work extra hard to keep your airway open. This is why you wake up with sudden jerks and gasps while sleeping. Central sleep apnea. A rare condition where your brain is the one making the amendments to your sleep. In central sleep apnea, your central nervous system fails to send important messages to the muscles of your respiratory tract to carry out the breathing process. These kinds of fallouts with the central nervous system usually occur when the body is already going through a rough patch and is struggling with disorders related to the heart, lungs, and kidneys. So, how are you supposed to know if you have this disorder? Well, suppose you find you have constant complaints about your snoring. In that case, it's high time to watch for symptoms like continuous restlessness during sleep, frequent awakenings due to gasping or choking, night sweats, headaches, sexual dysfunction, depressive mood disturbances, and daytime fatigue. The inability to have a restful slumber, or as we may call it, insomnia, may also be experienced by people with central sleep apnea. Once you figure you have sleep apnea, how does your doctor go about diagnosing it? Depending on your medical history and symptoms, your doctor may put you on a suitable sleep evaluation test. The home sleep test is a study performed at home without any specialized technician. It's used to diagnose moderate to severe obstructive sleep apnea patients. This study records fewer functions and cannot be used as a screening tool for patients with severe medical problems like neuromuscular disorders, cardiovascular diseases, or pulmonary diseases. In addition, other sleep disorders like insomnia, circadian rhythm disorders, narcolepsy, restless leg syndrome, and central sleep apnea aren't evaluated. Or doctors will suggest a polysomnogram. A polysomnogram, or PSG, is performed under direct supervision of a trained specialist. This detailed test gives a fairly deep analysis of body functions while sleeping. It keeps an eye on the electrical activity of the brain and records eye movements, breathing patterns, airflow, heart rate, muscle activity, and blood oxygen levels. The evaluation provides us with graded severity of disruptions, which makes it perfect for clear-cut diagnosis. What are all the health risks involved? Sleepiness or fatigue. Since you're not getting a healthy or sound sleep at night due to constant disruptions, it's apparent to feel sleepy all day. This not only reduces your effectiveness at the workplace, but also leads to irritable behaviors and mood fluctuations. Cardiovascular diseases. Obstructive sleep apnea increases the risk of heart failure by 140%. Disruption in oxygen supply for a longer interval puts pressure on the cardiovascular system. Your heart has to go the extra mile to keep your body functioning, and due to overload, it may develop complications like coronary heart disease, strokes, and heart attacks. Type 2 diabetes. Sleep apnea causes type 2 diabetes by pushing your body on the verge of insulin resistance. Of those already living with type 2 diabetes, about 80% have unrecognized sleep apnea. Other health issues like hypertension, increased cholesterol levels, breathing problems, and declining metabolism are also common. Once you've been diagnosed with sleep apnea, understanding what exactly caused this medical disorder is helpful. Several factors cause sleep apnea, most of which are avoidable. Obesity is a common factor in the development of sleep apnea, as more than 60% of obstructive sleep apnea cases occur due to excessive weight. Another avoidable cause is smoking and the use of alcohol or sedatives. According to a study, sleep apnea is 3 times more likely in those who smoke than non-smokers. While sedatives and alcohol may not necessarily lead to the development of sleep apnea, it does relax the muscles of your throat, thereby worsening a mild snoring issue. Smoking and consuming alcohol not only contributes to developing sleep apnea, but also develops severe health conditions in the long run. So, why not give them up when there's still time? You should avoid unhealthy habits like these entirely. Other factors that can trigger sleep apnea are already present in medical ailments. Problems with your heart, type 2 diabetes, high blood pressure, and Parkinson's disease increase the risk of obstructive sleep apnea. Other factors like age, family history, and nasal congestion also significantly contribute to the development of sleep apnea. Now, how to treat it? For mild cases, your doctor may suggest you make fundamental lifestyle changes. These lifestyle remedies include maintaining a healthy weight by exercising. Aim to keep the weight off because regaining any extra pounds makes it possible for the condition to return. Yoga is also an excellent exercise method to improve your sleep apnea. It helps you practice breathing techniques that will improve your oxygen levels. Doctors will also suggest moderate cases undergo continuous positive airway pressure therapy, or CPAP, or bilevel positive airway pressure therapy, BPAP. CPAP is administered through a mask required to be worn at night. High pressure air is then sent to your upper respiratory tract, helping smooth oxygen inflow with fewer or negligible disruptions in the passage. BPAP is used when CPAP therapy turns out to be ineffective. What BPAP machines do is make use of 2 pressures, pressure during inhalation and pressure during exhalation. Surgery is usually the last resort when the severity of sleep apnea leaves the mentioned methods ineffective. Sleep apnea is nothing but a condition that emanates from our lifestyle decisions. So, take some time out of your wellness and keep such troublesome situations at bay. Exercise, eat well, and sleep well. Wondering what other warning signs about your body you shouldn't ignore? Or want to learn more about wellness? Stay tuned to our channel and dive deeper into a sea of interesting topics related to your body. Watch 16 signs your blood sugar is high and 8 diabetes symptoms. Or 9 early warning signs of vitamin deficiency. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn more about staying fit and healthy. Do you snore a lot? Maybe even think you have sleep apnea? Let us know in the comments below.